new hip hop museum in the making. It's gonna be big. It's right across the street from the Museum of Hip Hop, where it's at right now. But look at this sucker, it's gonna be real big. And guess where it's gonna be? In the Bronx, where it all started at.
Thinking of a master plan.
Depicted the graphic and violent life of a street hustler.
Many other people who are attempting to create museums, and I send a shout out to them also. But ours is a over $100 million institution that's being built on Exterior Place in the Bronx at 149th. And it's just amazing. I actually started collecting the Paradise Collection in 1978. I was inspired by my brother, Michael, rest in peace, who collected baseball cards and comic books. And that got me into collecting And the minute I saw old school hip hop flyers made by Phase Two and those cats, the original cats that made flyers, I was hooked because they were incorporating Afrofuturism into the flyers, you know, science fiction flyers and comic book heroes on the flyers like Spider-Man and Iron Man. And, you know, I was a big fan of superheroes. So hip hop artists were like superheroes to me. The Grand Imperial DJ JC, Grand Master Flash, you know, Cool DJ Herc, you know what I mean? The Herculords, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Grandmaster Flowers, you know, it was like superheroes that were ghetto superstars. And I could relate to that. So I started collecting hip hop flyers and everything related to hip hop since back then. So over 12 years ago, I interfaced with my boy Rocky Buchano, the CEO and president of the Universal Hip Hop Museum, and I've been working with him ever since to bring it to reality. And along the way, I've been linking up with good friends of mine who are also collectors, who are also interested in preserving the culture and history of hip hop. My boy Pete Nice, the Prime Minister from Third Base.
Pete Nice.
My homegirl Kelly from LA, my homegirl Martha Diaz, you know what I'm saying? And my man Pop Master Fable from the Rocksteady crew. So there are collectors and purveyors of hip hop memorabilia and artifacts all over the world. And, you know, my boy Adam Silverstein from Switzerland, you know, Ed Young, who used to be the executive director of the Source magazine, you know. We all just came together and said, look, this has to be done. And if we can't do it, can't nobody.